The cornerstone of Windows security is Windows and TPM. If you've watched the first video on Trusted Platform Module, you'll understand the importance of TPM. As we look at the following feature sets that are being built in the Windows ecosystem based on TPM, much of this is enterprise level, but it is leaking down in to the consumer products such as Windows 10. Let's take a look at these feature sets. One, platform crypto provider. This is a critical feature of TPM and Windows, the Windows operating system. Windows Hello for Business. Windows Hello is some of those components are moving into the Windows 10 platform. This is an enterprise level, does require TPM support, and it provides both two-factor and three-factor authentication. BitLocker, drive encryption. This is enterprise level, and it's also in Windows 10. Measure boot. This is an amazing. This, as we saw in TPM video one, you saw how Junos is using it. Juniper Network is using it. How Chromebook is using this. Microsoft is going to be employing Measure Boot also in the Windows platform. Virtual smart cards allow the TPM to mimic a permanently installed or inserted smart card. Health attestation. This is going to take Measure Boot to a whole new level, allowing a managed platform for a Measure Boot. Although some of the features require additional hardware requirements, such as virtualization, TPM is the foundation. Let's take a look at a full list. This is a full list of all the Windows feature sets that are implementing some form of TPM. We have Measure Boot, which we're going to go into, BitLocker, Drive Encryption, Device Encryption, excuse me, Windows Defender Application Control, which is their fancy word for AppLocker, Windows Defender Exploit Guard, which does not use it, but is a great new security feature, Windows Defender System Guard, yes, Credential Guard, does support TPM. It doesn't require it. The device health attestation, you'll see that's very cool. Windows Hello for Business, and it is also in Windows 10. UEFI Secure Boot, Virtual Smart Card, Certificate Storage, Autopilot, Secure Bio, and DRTPM. Most of these are going to either support or require TPM in one fashion or form. Windows Hello for Business is an enterprise product. Now there's components of Windows Hello that is also being inserted into Windows 10. So what is it? It's all about replacing passwords. It also enables strong two-factor authentication, and there's the ability to add three-factor. Passwords are a problem. 81% of data breaches in 2016 involved weak, default, or stolen passwords. Passwords are a major problem. So Windows Hello is a new type of user credential. It's tied to your device. When you establish Windows Hello, you're tying a credential to your laptop, to your tablet. You can use biometric devices such as eye trackers, facial scanning, biometric fingerprint scanners, or a PIN. Hello for Business is a strong hardware-protected TPM two-factor credential that enables single sign-on to Azure Active Directory and Active Directory itself. Windows Hello is bringing a whole new world to the desktop, laptop, and devices. A world where the user never types their password, the user never changes their password, and the user doesn't even know their password. Windows Hello for Business is designed for cloud-only deployment, hybrid deployments, and also on-premise deployments. Windows Hello can be used on nearly every Windows 10 device in the world natively with a PIN. Let's get rid of the password. Why a PIN? Why is it better than a password? Well, on the surface, a PIN looks much like a password. You can see it here on the slide, but there's a big difference between a PIN and a password. Hello PIN brings in two-factor authentication and gets rid of all the risks and problems that a password brings. When you set up a Windows Hello PIN, it's tied specifically to the device it was set up, so that provides one factor authentication. The PIN provides a second factor authentication, and your PIN is backed by a TPM chip. If you want to sign on multiple devices, you have to set up a Windows Hello PIN on each device, giving you two-factor authentication. None of the risks, none of the problems. People can't steal your password because you don't have one. The PIN is local to the device. It isn't transmitted anywhere, and it isn't stored on any server. Here you can see in the Windows security settings, I've got my Windows Hello, and this is where I set up my PIN, and I use Windows Hello PIN on every device I have. Well, that's great. I'm getting rid of my passwords. My PC is more secure, but what about my online banking? What about my online shopping? Wouldn't it be nice to have a more secure form of communication and shopping experience online? Well, Windows Hello has worked with the FIDO Alliance, and they're bringing Windows Hello and FIDO2 security keys. Windows Hello now supports FIDO2 USB security keys. This will provide strong three-factor authentication to many web-based applications. Although many vendors are now using the FIDO2 compliant security keys, Windows Hello only works with two vendors, Yubico and Feten. They support because they are three-factor. They require the device, they require the key, and they require fingerprint. So, if you're looking at using the FIDO2 compliant security keys with Windows, be sure to use these two vendors. Google and many other companies are using FIDO compliant security keys and they do not require these two vendors. You can use the FIDO keys to even log on to your Microsoft account. So what if I don't have this Yubico security key? Can I still take advantage of Windows Hello and three-factor authentication? Well, yes, you can. Windows Hello also brings to Windows 10 dynamic lock, and it works with your Bluetooth pairing of your phone to your PC or your laptop. Once you're out of range of your phone, your PC will lock automatically. So now you get automatic three-factor authentication, the device that you set up your PIN, and your phone. So now you have three devices that authenticate you. By the way, this is very, very cool. Here's an example of the dynamic lock in Windows 10 security settings. You can set this up, pair your phone to your PC or your tablet or your laptop, and off you go. You've got three-factor authentication. BitLocker is a well-understood technology that takes advantage of encrypting the hard drive, and yes, it requires a TPM. BitLocker does allow you to run it without a TPM chip, but for the best experience, you want to have a TPM chip involved. Here we see BitLocker can be turned on here on our control panel. Every vendor, every company, whether it's Apple, Microsoft, Oracle, Linux, everybody is grappling with the problem of how can I make sure that the operating system from the time I boot to its full runtime state is not been compromised, has not had malicious code added. How can I do that? Microsoft is going to use TPM and is going to introduce measured boot. At the top of our graph, you can take a look at an unsecured boot process. Here we hit the power button. We assume that all of that is good. Firmware is good. We assume that the bootloader is the right bootloader, that it executes the kernel. All the drivers are correct. And then the rest of the operating system is loaded, services are loaded, and then the user logs on and the apps, etc. But that is totally unsecured. Secure, and we do not know really the state of that operating system. We don't know if it's been hacked, if it's got malicious code in it. That is where we are today. Let's move down to the next one, a measured boot, where we take hash values of the firmware. We take hash values of the bootloader. We take hash values of every step of the entire boot process. That is verified by hash values in the TPM. That value then can be then sent against an IT manifest in the cloud, looking and comparing between TPM measured values, what is stored in the cloud, and we can verify then that that operating system is absolutely legitimate from boot to runtime. So to get an idea of how measured boot works, this is a measured boot tool created by Microsoft, and you can see how it's running against the operating system as the Windows operating system loads. And you can see it looks at every single file that is booted up and validates it. Now, central to this whole concept is the Trusted Platform module. It provides our core root of trust. Measurements are reset on every boot, so stored inside the TPM are hash values of known good measurements, whether we're talking about the firmware, the bootloader, the kernel, the operating system, the drivers, and those are systematically checked against the TPM's values. All of this provides a chain of trust from the boot to the runtime. Now, Microsoft is not the only one that's doing this type of really rethinking security from the ground up. Linux has an alliance called Core Boot. I showed you how Juniper Networks is using it in their routers. I think this is going to be the standard soon. Health attestation is a way that we can take measure boot to the next level. Here's what it's going to do. We're going to have our Windows 10 machine down here. And what we're going to do is we're going to boot it up, and it's going to have a TPM device. We're going to then come up to our identity provider, Active Directory, Azure. We're going to authenticate the user. Then we're going to communicate to our management system. The management system will then require that the secured attestation server communicate to the TPM and review those measured hash values. Is this device secure? Has anything been added or malicious code been added, malware, whatever? And once it gets a clean bill of health, then the last, it can access the assets, files, application servers. This is already in place. You can run Windows Intune as your mobile management device. That Microsoft has a couple of them, but they also support third-party packages to do this entire process. So you can see here that TPM 2.0 is the fundamental core root of trust for this entire process. You can see that this health attestation gives us a chance to measure the boot and verify that at runtime, the operating system is good. In the future, we'll be able to take real-time measurements of a running machine and monitor in real time and be able to respond in seconds to any threat on the operating system. Think of how critical this is needed in a data center where you have massive data centers and servers and storage devices that do not reboot every day. You need this type of technology to monitor your data center and validate that your systems are secure. With Microsoft's Windows and TPM, enterprises can now roll out virtual smart cards. They can get rid of those physical devices and still have that two-factor authentication needed for the employee. Virtual smart cards emulate the functionality of physical smart cards, but they use the trusted platform module, the TPM chip. This is basically an enterprise feature of Windows. You need application developers and IT admins to deploy virtual smart cards. I hope you've enjoyed this presentation on Windows ecosystem and the TPM and the foundation that TPM is bringing to security features in the Windows system. Many of these enterprise features are migrating in small pieces and parts into even the consumer side of Windows 10. Next time you buy a device, make sure it has TPM. Thank you.